One of the very important aspects when we talk about any particular disease is how well are we protected from it, not only in terms of drugs, vaccines, or other sort of treatment, but the insurance, that is the health insurance. And the health insurance policies which are there in the market do cater to and do take care of most of the illnesses or most of the diseases which we suffer from. COVID-19, that is coronavirus, is a new phenomena, and how the health insurance companies are offering their products, that's one part. And now recently, the insurance regulator, that is IRDAI, has come up with new guidelines for the health insurance companies to offer their products to protect the common people from COVID-19, that is health insurance specifically for COVID-19. So today we will talk about all these aspects. And for this, we're joined by a distinguished panel of guests. Let me first introduce the guest to you, beginning with Mr. Suresh Mathur. He is the executive director with IRDAI, the insurance regulator. We're also joined by Mr. R.K. Srivastava. He is a former Director General of Health Services, that is DGHS. We're also joined by Mr. Krishnan Ramachandran. He is the MD and CEO of Max Bupa Health Insurance Company. Let me begin with you, Mr. Mathur, and let's start by trying to understand as to what kind of guidelines has IRDAI come up with in terms of COVID-specific health insurance, and what kind of products are we looking at when you, you know, bring those guidelines or those features in place?
Yeah, just to give a brief, we have taken a lot of initiatives at IRDA for the to ensure that the policyholders' interests are protected in these difficult times. We have been continuously assessing the effect of pandemic on the insurance industry, and just to tell you, initially in the initial days we have advised insurers to expedite claims relating to COVID and instructed that any COVID-specific claim shall not be repudiated without being reviewed thoroughly. So in respect of existing policies, we have given grace period during the lockdown period for the benefits and as well as for the renewal of premium so that coverage will be there during the lockdown period. Mm-hmm. Also, we have facilitated the payment of premiums by installments in the health insurance claims. In order to expedite settlement of claims, we have also mandated that turnaround time for settlement of COVID claims should be 2 hours for granting cashless pre-authorization and also during the discharge. Mm-hmm. We have also advised insurers to accept electronic submissions of documents because during the lockdown, it is difficult for the patients to get all the documents. So, and we have also advised insurers to give wide publicity to these relaxations which IRDA has given. Mm-hmm. We have also issued norms on telemedicine recently. And now that you have asked for the product, we have recently come up with two products. One is called Corona Kavach, which is indemnity-based policy. And another one is the benefit-based policy, which is called Corona Raksha. Mm-hmm. So I'll briefly tell you about the Corona Kavach. The name will be Corona Kavach, then the company name. And basically, it is an individual policy. And it can be given as a floater in the family. It is available on individual and also on the basis of quota sum insured basis. So there will be one base cover, which is COVID hospitalization cover, and one optional cover is also there, which is benefit-based hospital daily cash.
Okay.
The sum insured will be between 550,000 and up to 5 lakhs in the multiples of 50,000. Waiting period will be 15 days. And the policy period we have kept is 3.5 months, 6.5 months, and 9.5 months to ensure that 15 days waiting period is covered in there. So at present, only the policy period is 3.5, 6.5, and 9.5. Mm-hmm. The persons between the age of 18 years to 65. Yes, we have mandated that they can be covered. the insurance can cover more than 65 also, but we have mandated up to 65. If anybody asks for it, has to be given, and all insurers will have to make this product available. And we have said that by 10th July it should be ready. So these are the initial things.
Okay. One very important aspect here is, Mr. Mathur, and before I go to Mr. Ramchandran, is are there any existing products which deal with COVID-19, or will these be specific products, or top ups on top of what existing policies a customer might have?
No, the existing policy also covers this thing, but this is in addition to the existing policies if anybody wishes to take. So it can be made available, and everybody will come to know what are the terms and conditions of the policy, since it is uniform for all the insurers. Let me tell you a little bit about the Corona Rakshak, which is benefit-based policy.
Mm-hmm.
This is for individuals only, and the sum insured will be from 50,000 to 2,50,000. Policy period is same, like 3.5 months, 6.5 months, and 9.5 months. Waiting period is also 15 days, and it can also be availed from 18 years of age to 65 years of age.
Okay.
For the persons.
Okay.
So in this case, lump sum benefit of equal 100% of the sum insured shall be payable on positive diagnosis of COVID, which will require at least a minimum of continuous 72 hours of hospitalization.
Okay. Okay, let me bring in Mr. Ramchandran here. Mr. Ramchandran, the kind of, two products which Mr. Mathur mentioned. One very important question here, which, viewers would want to understand is, how different are these products from the existing products which the customers might have and which covers COVID-19 as a disease? That's one. And two, how would these two products help the individuals who go ahead and want to take the benefit of these health insurance products?
Oh, sure. I think if I have to put myself into the regulator's shoes and the thought process, and also I just want to step back a little bit in terms of what the thrust of what the IRD has been doing. Number one, as Mr. Mathur pointed out, there's been a lot of emphasis and proactive emphasis on policyholder protection. With a large number of measures that he outlined very much are around how do we make sure that policyholders are helped in these troubling times. Second, broadly, if I look at the thrust of what the regulator has been doing, there is an increased emphasis on standardization. And standardization, in my mind, helps build trust. And I come to the point on what it means from a product standpoint, Vishal.
Mm-hmm.
Lastly, I think there is an emphasis on affordability. The Arogya Sanjeevani product that the regulator announced and is now available in the market, combines both aspects of standardization and affordability. So the thinking here is that, how can we make available a standard product which is affordable and brings into the fold first-time insurance buyers?
Mm-hmm.
So broadly, depending on, for example, as Max Bupa, we feel that there's an amazing opportunity for us to take the Arogya Sanjeevani product, which is already standardized and affordable to the, to the masses of the country. And the new product, which the regulator has now suggested that the industry offer, as Mr. Mathur, pointed out,
mm-hmm.
in some sense stands on top of that, or for people who cannot afford Arogya Sanjeevani, this is probably a good introductory product for them. So I think in keeping in mind the two imperatives of, or the three imperatives of policyholder protection, standardization, and affordability, I'd say there are a number of routes that the insurance industry can take, all of which ultimately will go into increasing insurance awareness and health insurance penetration, Vishal. So that's how I would look at it.
Okay, but a more specific and a more direct question here, to coming back to these two policies, since we are in COVID times and you know these are very crucial times, people are anxious as well. As a consumer, Mr. Ramachandran, if I want to understand, one, why should I go for either of these two products? That is Corona Kavach or Corona Rakshak. And if I want to go, which one should I go for?
So as a consumer, I would say my decision-making process would be, if I can afford to buy a full-fledged insurance product, whether that's any insurance product available in the market or the Arogya Sanjeevani product, that should be my first choice. Now, if I have an affordability issue and I am worried about what's happening around Corona, then these two products fit the bill. Or if I want additional protection specifically around Corona, to what Mr. Mathur said, then I should look at the two products that the regulator has mandated. But if you ask me, if I have purchasing power and I can afford it, given that we have installments already available, go for a full-fledged insurance product. If that's, you want additional protection, then Corona Kavach comes in. Or if you're not able to afford the full-fledged product, considering COVID times, as you called it, think about Corona Kavach. So that would mentally be the decision-making process I would adopt, Vishal.
Okay. Okay. So it's up to individual needs and individual, process, decision-making process out there to understand what they actually they need and which kind of product should they go for. But let me bring in Mr. Srivastav here as well. Mr. Srivastav, you heard both the gentlemen in terms of the features which we are talking about, the guidelines which we are talking about. How would you look at this scenario wherein these two kind of products are being brought into the market? And obviously, this is one particular health crisis which needs a lot of focus on all aspects, and specifically health insurance as well.
Okay, Vishal, I have heard both the persons, and I must appreciate that a lot of thing has been initiated at the end of the IRDA and the various private insurance sector persons, and they add value to the demand which is coming out very clearly from those who are trying to take healthcare provisions, but they don't have enough money in relation to the COVID. Uh-huh. If you look at the figure today, we have got a market size of round about 2 lakh plus persons who are under active treatment, and this number will keep on increasing. And if we look at individual hospitalized care, then it amounts to round about 10% of them. So the market size is quite huge, and it has got enough scope of any type of policy, whether it is a Kavach based or Rakshak based or a comprehensive policy. But from the user's point of view, as a consumer of the insurance services for the COVID specific time and for the COVID specific management, as a consumer, what I will look for? I will like to look at a thing which is cost effective, which is affordable to me, mm-hmm. and which provide coverage to the highest risk group of the population. So it means there are certain exclusions which has happened in Kavach and Rakshak, that is 65 plus. That provision needs to be expedited unrelated to the premium of the insurance. The second thing is, which I will look for it, the timeline which has been fixed up mm-hmm. on the policy, and the whole cycle of cashless or reimbursement system which will be there, that cycle should be so perfect that a insured person, according to the type of policy, what I am saying that the bad situation in private sector where these insurance services will be provided is not giving a choice to the end user to restrict to the network which these policies select. And therefore, there should be a freedom of going for a cashless treatment to any type of hospital, which will make the thing quite easy and quite perfect for an end user.
Okay.
These two things added, I hope a policy like this will become a positive thing for the end user. And without these things, it will cause more worry to the patient because he is not sure whether he will get the bed which is listed over there in that particular hospital. The availability cannot be assured. So all these things will create a lot of problem to the end user, and this will cause a problem before they decide to go for buying a policy and buying a particular product.
Okay. Okay. Mr. Mathur and Mr. Ramchandran, I'll come to you one by one on these suggestions, quite interesting and important ones coming in from Mr. Srivastava. First, you, Mr. Mathur, has the IRDA taken care of all these aspects in terms of making it cost effective, affordable, and also ensuring that the end user does not end up struggling to get the final benefit out of the policy?
First thing I will mention that, as Dr. Srivastava mentioned, that the hospital should be in network. So we have issued instructions to insurers to ensure that they are able to bring more and more hospitals under the network coverage so that cashless can be given. If the hospital is not in the network, then it goes into the reimbursement claim. So our effort is to ensure that more and more hospitals come in the network, hospital network. And they are listed with the Rohini portal, mm-hmm. which is with the Insurance Information Bureau.
Okay.
So that effort we have done. Regarding the product, this product will be widely available, and we have mandated that particularly the Corona Kavach, which is indemnity based, we have mandated that all insurers should make available this product to any person who ask for it after the underwriting.
Okay.
And then the Corona Rakshak, which is benefit-based policy, that also we have said that all insurers, general health and life, will endeavor to offer this kind of a product. And this is the short-term product. I think this will not be very costly, as Mr. Ramachandran and Dr. Srivastava already have mentioned that anybody can buy this product from anywhere, and it will be available and made available by every insurer.
Okay. Mr. Ramchandran, your views on that, specifically the cost effectiveness and affordability when the final product is out?
I think there's only one caveat that I want to add here, Vishal and Mr. Mathur, which is that for sustainability and affordability, and this is a topic that we have discussed many times in the past, it is important that the entire value chain, which is insurance plus healthcare delivery, be looked at in totality.
Mm-hmm.
Because our ability to consistently and sustainably deliver affordability is a function of what is the cost of healthcare delivery. And as we know that healthcare delivery has fairly variable costs. We also know that Corona is, the length of stay is 10, 11 days, especially in the critical cases. There are additional costs on PPEs, etc., that the providers need to factor in. So while the endeavor will definitely be to make it affordable, and that's clearly the regulator's intent and the industry's intent as well, but for this to be sustainable, as a country, we have to find a way to solve affordability end to end. Not only from an insurance premium standpoint, but all the way across the value chain, to say that, look, we have to make healthcare affordable for all Indians, and if insurance is the means to make that affordable, then how do we have transparency across the value chain? How do we reduce variability? How do we have more accountability end to end in the value chain? I think that is a very important aspect that needs to be addressed, and we should not lose sight of.
Okay.
Clearly, the endeavor is affordability, but it's more complex than only insurance premium affordability, Vishal.
Okay, definitely. That's a very important point out there. Entire ecosystem will have to be, a very comprehensive and you know, variables out there which you were talking about, Mr. Ramachandran. But that brings me to this aspect in terms of the health insurance sector. If we take a look at the sector as a whole, then in the previous financial year, the year-on-year growth was quite significant. And that's one particular indication that we are on the right path in terms of ensuring that everyone gets insured in terms of health insurance. Are we or are we not, Mr. Ramachandran?
We are on the right path, definitely, and the awareness of insurance has gone up dramatically. But we have a long way to go, Vishal. I think we still need to cover maybe 300, 350 million Indians, and collectively our effort between the regulators' development agenda and the industry's efforts, we still have about 300 million to cover.
And as an industry representative, what would you suggest to ensure that is done effectively?
So I think a number of measures that have been taken, that have been undertaken in terms of improving trust, whether that is standardization, whether that's around affordability, ease of process, I think those measures will definitely help. I think in the current awareness, we should multiply the efforts around further increasing awareness around insurance. And I might even go to the next step of saying, look, what can we do to sort of make it mandatory for all Indians to have insurance?
Mm-hmm.
You know, if motor insurance is sort of mandatory, why not think about saying, okay, we want all Indians to have health insurance, and then work backwards to say, what can we do to make that happen? I think that's probably the thought process we need to get into at this point.
Okay. Mr. Srivastav, your views on that in terms of, increasing the reach of the health insurance? Because obviously, this particular crisis has given up a wake-up call to those who might not have so far taken the health insurance aspect seriously as well.
I think I have got my view from the consumer's angle.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Indian are not very insurance-friendly type of population.
Mm-hmm.
Their track record is different. They feel that the healthcare should be free of cost. During last 20 years, gradually, the health insurance sector has started putting a footprint into the overall payer system of the health services. The slowness of the growth of this particular sector indirectly shows that somewhere the public end user finds it that the investment they are going to make in this sector, that investment is not proportionate to the care and the services they are getting. I 100% agree that the things are increasing, that the number is increasing, but the mere entry of the public insurance system, that is the government insurance system, that is the Ayushman Bharat scheme, is indicative that the end user is still trying to have free healthcare services. Now, if we look at it into the total perspective, during the COVID period, what we see that everybody who has got a fear of having COVID or who has acquired the COVID, they will go for health insurance. Their mindset will compel them to go for health insurance. Are our product which we are offering today through these two schemes and the comprehensive scheme which is coming from the other private sectors, are these products fulfill their demand? I look at it from a different angle. The total demand is of having a suspicion of COVID and the cost incurred on it for testing, having a home isolation, having a hospitalization without oxygen, having a hospitalization with oxygen, having a ICU care, having certain type of comorbid conditions which are there in many of them and require many more interventions. So all these things are taken care of that. And this fear is mostly among those who are 65 plus, because they always have these NCD along with that. So that fear is not properly addressed in all these policies. Unless and until that type of fear is being addressed, the further movement will be difficult. The second thing is that public is feeling that government hospital and private hospitals are overwhelming. These 10,000 beds which are being created, that 5,000 beds which are being created, they will never come in the network. So in case they get COVID-19, at that time when the hospital beds are not available, then what will happen? They have to pay and go for reimbursement. And when they pay and go for reimbursement, then all those type of things which comes in the final payment, which ultimately reduces the payment about 50% or 40% of the total cost, that is also there, that is also a fear in their mind. So I still feel that these policies should be made much more simpler, focused to the product which are in demand by majority of patients, so that cater to the largest number of the chunk which is available, and this number will keep on increasing.
So that's a very important point which Mr. Srivastava has brought in from a consumer's perspective, specifically that the products have to be simpler and focused as well. Let's have concluding comments from Mr. Mathur here. Mr. Mathur, from the regulator's point of view, we heard Mr. Ramachandran's point from an industry perspective, and Dr. Srivastava from consumer's perspective. From a regulator's perspective, it's not only about these crucial COVID times, but overall health insurance as a product and its penetration, which needs to be done at a much larger scale. But obviously, consumers' interests will also have to be taken in concern here.
Yeah. First thing I will mention that these two products which we have mandated for the insurers, they are very simple. Very simple to understand, and very simple language has been used in these products. And it is uniform across board.
Okay.
So I think the policyholders will have that comfort and benefit that they understand this thing. First thing. Then he has mentioned whether the payments will be paid. Payments will be made if other than hospital, if other facilities of beds is done somewhere else and not in the hospitals. That also we have mentioned to the insurers that they should consider these claims, particularly if the quarantine is not in the hospital at some other place. But if all the facilities exist there, they should consider and pay also.
Mm-hmm.
And we have also mentioned to all the insurers that they should make an effort to include more and more hospitals under the network.
Okay.
So that the policyholders are not put to any disadvantage anywhere.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So these are the instructions which we have issued, and this will
Long-term perspective, Mr. Mathur, long-term perspective in terms of health insurance products penetration, and the path on which we are right now.
Yes. Long term, we are thinking a lot of things long term. A lot of initiatives are in the pipeline. Like we are also coming up with a platform where there will be seamless transfer of data from the hospitals to the third party administrator, all the insurers. And which will ensure that the payments of claims will be very fast, and there will be less frauds in the whole system. So that is in the pipeline. Also,
okay.
There is a talk of another platform where products like the council may take up this initiative.
Okay.
The council, that the products of all the companies will be available on the web, and the persons can choose which suits them. Also,
okay.
There are web aggregators and brokers in the market who can guide the policyholders and the prospective policyholders on this issue.
Okay. Those are definitely, you know, good initiatives are being taken in from the long-term perspective. We're running short of time. Otherwise, you know, there are several other aspects as well which can be brought in here discussion when we talk about the overall growth of the health insurance sector and the need for these products as well. But meanwhile, thank you so much, Mr. Mathur, Mr. Ramchandran, and Dr. Srivastava for sharing your views and time with us here on Rajya Sabha Television. There it is for our viewers, laid down exactly how these two products with respect to COVID-19 or coronavirus, which the IRDA has come out with guidelines, these two products will benefit. And let's wait for the insurance companies to come out with the final products and different features, what they have. But the idea here is to go ahead and ensure that we are fully prepared